A new book, Sanctify Them in Truth, by Father Jeff Kirby, takes on key issues in our society today. In his book, Father Kirby highlights the importance of addressing abortion above all other issues. The book guides readers through church teaching on life and equips readers with the tools and resources to navigate today's contentious world that is against the Catholic Church, its truth, and its beauty. And we are joined now by Father Jeff Kirby, author of Sanctify Them in Truth. Father Kirby, thanks for joining us. Tell us about your book and what you hope readers will take away from it.
Yes, thank you, Prudence, for this opportunity. This book really comes from the trenches. It started actually as a homily series from emails from parishioners to me saying, Father, could you please address some of these issues, issues that they were getting from coworkers or their neighborhoods or homeowners associations or on the sideline of youth sports events. And they're like, Father, please help us to understand what the church teaches. So the book really comes from the trenches. So it seeks to address the issues that Christians are facing in everyday life. So from the LGBTQ plus movement to immigration to critical race theory to questions of abortion to gender equality, each of these issues, the church has an answer to these social questions. And so in this book, I wanted to present as thoroughly as possible, as readably as possible, the answers of the church to these social questions.
Very important. And you write that science makes it clear that life begins at conception. Can you explain how you address this truth when pro-abortion advocates come up against you and choose to differ, not just from a scientific perspective, but also a moral one?
Yes. So here at my parish, we pray in front of the local abortion facility every month as an entire parish family. We go, several hundred people. And so that confrontation you're speaking about is actually a very real experience in my own ministry. And I think that oftentimes we appeal to science, to embryology, and we look at ultrasound technology. It's clear that life begins at conception. It's clear that this is a human being. We try to speak that truth as charitably as possible. And in terms of the moral argument that, we share this human dignity. Like, we can't argue for human dignity in any other aspect if we don't argue for the dignity of all human life, especially at its most vulnerable and beginning stages. So we attempt to have these conversations, but so oftentimes what happens is attempts at civil discourse become appeals to emotion, become name-calling, and oftentimes as we are trying to seek, share the truth, to speak the truth, oftentimes we have these names thrown at us, and yet in spite of that, we try as best we can to present the truth, to present the gospel, and to have our arguments in place so that we have a peace even as we're being yelled at or being called names, that we can try as best we can to share this truth with others.
Yes, and Father, we recently saw some disturbing videos circulating on social media of events titled Drag the Kids to Pride. These are events that are drag shows that are targeted at young children. And in one instance, a pride event was even being promoted by a satanic temple in the state of Idaho. So as good Catholics, how do we combat these such clear evils and, these people who are attacking the innocence of our young children?
Yes, I think first and foremost, Christian parents really have to understand the vocation that they have received to guard the innocence of their children. I think as Christians throughout our communities, we have to understand that the spiritual battle that's before us. St. Paul reminds us that our battle is not with human beings, with flesh and blood, but with powers and principalities, which means we have to pray, we have to fast, we have to stand up and speak the truth in love, we have to defend truth, we have to use the process of laws and policies that have been established in our society in order to bring about even greater good. So I think the idea or the possibility of a Christian being passive in the past is over. If we're going to be Christians now, if we're going to take our faith seriously, we really are called to be more active, to be more engaged in order to be involved, to find out what's happening. A lot of these situations and various things that we see with the LGBTQ plus movement, and the list goes on, by the way, as you've described some. I mean, there are a whole list of people, therapists being brought into public schools without parental knowledge and coaching and counseling, young people these gay proms that some high schools are having now and so on. So we see this all throughout the board. And a lot of times parents don't even know this is happening. So I think that we're aware of some of this because of the context in which the pandemic placed us, where parents were now paying a little more attention. And so I would encourage parents to keep that attentiveness, as well as any Christian who cares about the common good, as we all should. We were called to be good Samaritans, so to pay attention, to speak the truth, to make sure that we're calling upon the spiritual resources, using those in terms of a spiritual response, but also, you know, finding our tongues and our backbones and speaking the truth and defending it.
Right. Father Kirby, you have so many good insights to share. Where can people find your book?
Yeah, so the book's available through the publisher, St. Benedict Press, TAM Books, or any local Catholic bookstore, as well as through Amazon.
Wonderful. Well, Father Jeff Kirby, thank you so much for joining us, author of Sanctify Them in Truth. God bless you.
Thanks, Prudence.